Right. So what about the family members and the assets of the family members of a judge? What happens? I mean, the family members, the immediate family, as well as a slightly distant family. How would you clarify that? How
well,
would you?
I don't know. When I declare my assets, I should declare the assets of that there also. Because you see, supposing, for example, when I became a judge, I was owning property worth about 70 lakhs. Just assuming. If after long tenure or whatever may be the tenure, by reason of my savings, if my account ultimately has swollen up to 1 crore or 1.25 crore, people won't suspect. But suddenly, when I retire, if my assets have swollen to 5 crores, what will you think of me? The judges have no other income excepting the salaries.
That's true.
Perks are not included, the salaries. From out of the salary, I have saved so much, and therefore, from 70 lakhs, it has gone to 5 crore means, what is the inference that is drawn? See, this is why I say it is better in your own interest. See, don't. Caesar's wife must be above reproach. Therefore, in your own interest, you do it. People are not going to suspect you. There are hundreds of people. Today, for example, there are hundreds of judges willing.
Right.
For example, one judge from Punjab and Haryana High Court has voluntarily declared. Though, of course, Justice Shailendra Kumar went to the extreme extent of writing in a newspaper, which was wholly uncalled for. I'm sorry to say that, because he should not have done it. See, this is purely, the entire judiciary constitutes one family. You can't say the Chief Justice of India has no jurisdiction. That's where, in my humble opinion, he went wrong. He could have written a letter to the Chief Justice of India, sir, I don't accept, but I propose to declare. Why do you make it public? It's not a public affair. What is happening inside a family, what happens between brothers, or what happened between a husband and wife, why should you make it public? Therefore, I strongly feel Justice Shailendra Kumar of Karnataka High Court was wrong in going to the press about this. If he had any grievance, however genuine it may be, he should have written a confidential letter to the Chief Justice of India.
All right.
So what do you think now about the judges at the High Court level? Do you think that they should go along with this as well? What's your opinion?
I told you, whether High Court or Supreme Court, they are constitutional officers.
They should.
Appointed by the President of India under seal. Therefore, they should come forward, whether High Court or Supreme Court. Now, if you don't say, I will not file. If I don't file, then how can you call upon the district judge or the subordinate judge or a judicial magistrate to declare his assets? Same logic will apply, isn't it? He may say no.
So it should go all the way.
Therefore, all the way. The entire judiciary must present a picture of being men possessed of high integrity. That is the only qualification. You may compromise with the intelligence of a judge, but never, never the integrity.
Now, we have this campaign for judicial accountability and reform very clearly saying, as a reaction to the outcome of the meeting yesterday, that this does not obviate the need for a law to declare assets. Your thoughts on that?
I am of the personal view there is no need for a law at all. When the law comes in, then the control will go away from the judiciary, because the law will govern. And the law may be held in by several restrictions we do not know. Therefore, I strongly feel you can avoid the law. It can be a convention, and it will become well established in course of time, that every judge on the date of joining must declare his assets. When he is sworn in as a judge, he must declare his assets. You make that convention, that will be easier. There is no need for a law. Why should you have legislative control over it?
All right. In fact, the demand was not judiciary alone. It was spread across the board, in fact, for all other public servants as well. Do you think there is a necessity of a law for even
no,
a little
I personally
abiding?
Again would reiterate, there is absolutely no necessity for a law. Yeah. Convention can be established right now that every judge on the date, just as he files his date of birth certificate, let him file his declaration also. Nothing wrong. You see, you ask for a date of birth certificate, you ask for a medical certificate, likewise you ask for a declaration of assets.
All right.
Yes.
Right. Now, of course, we've been going along for so many years without judges actually declaring their assets. From your experience, Justice Mohan, do you think there'll be any kind of resistance from certain, certain...
Yes, there was.
There will be.
There was.
And will there continue to be?
There was. During my time, no such proposal came. Nevertheless, people did not like this kind of control because they felt there was no necessity. Who are they to ask? Why should the public know about me? The problem is, once you start that attitude, why should the public know? See, kindly remember, the judges are to serve the public, rendering impartial justice. Therefore, the public have a right to expect from you, not only fairness, that how do I get myself established, or how do I myself get convinced that you are a man of integrity? Supposing, for example, if the case goes against me, and if an allegation is made that there was some other influence, monetary or otherwise, then I am not getting fair justice. Therefore, it is better, again and again I will say, the judges should not shun this. There is absolutely no necessity. Straight away, all right. I say, look, my hands are clean. I am prepared. See, you want a high constitutional office. Otherwise, you could have remained as an advocate, or you could have gone to some other profession.
Right.
You want to occupy a high constitutional office, then you must be worthy of that.
In fact, they have moral responsibilities.
Yes, what they have great.